Dear students, if you remember, we had started discussing the poem on killing a tree. We had discussed the first two stanzas. In the first stanza, the poet describes a feeding tree, how a tree grows up. In the second stanza, the poet describes the resilience of a tree, the power of the tree to go back to its former condition. It is not easy to kill a tree because a tree cannot be killed by the simple stroke of a knife. And even if the branches are hacked and chopped, again, new branches will come out and the small twigs that come out will become big branches. That means the tree has enough resilience to withstand these assaults. In the last two stanzas, the poet gives a systematic, a blow-by-blow description of how a tree can be killed. Now, let us come to the third stanza. No, the root is to be pulled out. Why the word no? Actually, this word no has relation to the line in the second stanza. The first line of the second stanza, so hack and chop. Hacking and chopping is not enough. The poet says no. Just by hacking and chopping, we will not be able to kill a tree. That is why the word no. Then how can a tree be killed? The root is to be pulled out. The root, that means the tree has to be uprooted. The root is the most vital part of a tree, because the root is the supply line of the tree. Through the root, the tree gets water, the tree gets its nourishment. So if the roots can be destroyed, only then the tree can be killed. The root is to be pulled out. Out of the anchoring earth. What is meant by the term anchor? The word anchor means a device that keeps a ship or a boat in position. In Bengali it is called nomur. But anchor is also a verb. Anchoring earth, that means the earth that is anchoring the tree, that means supporting the tree, securing the tree in its position. The roots of the tree go deep inside the earth. And it is the earth, the soil, that secures the tree, that keeps the tree firmly in its position. That's why the term anchoring earth. The root is to be taken out of this soil. It is to be roped, tied and pulled out. Roped, tied. That means tied with a rope. The uprooting of the tree should be followed by tying a rope around the trunk of the tree. Gache guri chardike dori bandhte hobe. The trunk has to be roped and tied and pulled out. Snapped out or pulled out entirely. To snap out. To snap out means to pull out, to take out or remove completely. Entirely means wholly or completely. The roots have to be taken out of the soil completely. Out from the earth cave. Earth cave is a very interesting term. The word cave means a hollow inside the mountain. In Bengali it is called guha. But what is earth cave? When the roots are pulled out, there is a big hollow on the ground. Matite gorto hoye jabe. That is the earth cave. So when the roots are pulled out of the earth, there will be a big hollow on the earth's surface. That is the earth cave. And the strength of the tree exposed. The strength of the tree is the root. The root is the strength of the tree, not the trunk, not the branches, not the leaves. Why is the root the strength of the tree? The root is the strength of the tree because it is the supply line of the tree. If the supply line is cut off, the tree will die. The strength of the tree exposed. Exposed means revealed. Prakashita hoa. The roots are under the earth. The roots are hidden. But now the roots have been taken out from the soil. The roots have been exposed. The roots have been revealed. The source, white and wet. The source of the tree is the root. The poet has used two adjectives to describe the roots, white and wet. Why is that root white? The root is white because it has been lying under the ground for many years and it has not received any sunlight. If a thing does not receive sunlight, it becomes white. And wet because it is the root which absorbs the water. That's why the root is wet. The most sensitive, hidden for years inside the earth. Sensitive. Sensitive means something that readily responds to a stimulus. Ja uttejona shohojei shara dey take bole sensitive. In Bengali, shongbedanshil. What is the most sensitive part of a tree? The most sensitive part of a tree is its root. And that root has been hidden for years inside the earth. Naturally, the roots lie under the ground. But now the roots have been exposed. Because that is the only way to kill a tree. A tree cannot be killed by hacking and or chopping the branches or by stabbing it with a knife. No. The supply line must be severed. The supply line must be snapped. Only then the tree can be killed. But the matter does not end there. The uprooting of the tree, the pulling out the roots is just the first stage of killing the tree. Now the poet gives a systematic description of how a tree can be killed. The first step is uprooting. That means removing the roots from the soil. Then the matter of scorching and choking in sun and air. Scorch means to burn. Now, the roots have been taken out. The tree will be hacked and chopped. And the parts of the tree, the trunk, the branches, the leaves, will be kept under the sun. To scorch means to burn. The heat of the sun will burn the tree, the branches, the parts of the tree. It will choke it. What is meant by the word choke? To choke means to cut off the supply line of air. Shashrutthukara. What will happen if the branches and the trunk of the tree are kept in sun and air? Ultimately, what will happen? The cells will die because the sunlight will burn it. The supply of oxygen will be cut off and the cells will die. The tree will dry up. Browning, hardening. These are the next two steps for killing a tree. What is the natural color of the tree? The natural color of the tree is green. But when it is kept in sun and air, ultimately the tree loses its greenery. It becomes brownish. It hardens. Just as after the death of a person, rigor mortis sets in. Manush mara gele. Rigor mortis, peshi aste aste shokt hoye jay. Similarly, the tree will also harden. Then the next step is twisting. To twist means to make it out of shape, to distort it out of shape. Muchre deva. Then the parts of the tree have to be twisted. The last step is withering. Withering means drying up. The tree dries up. And then it is done. It means the killing of a tree. And now the killing of the tree is completed. So actually here the poet describes the perversity of the action of killing a tree. Ekta gachke marar moddhe je bikriti ache, the poet exposes it. Actually he gives a blow-by-blow description of the killing of a tree. This question may be asked, how can a tree be killed? First of all, the roots have to be taken out of the earth. Because the root is the supply line of the tree. And then the parts of the tree will have to be kept in sun and air. And what will happen? The parts of the tree will dry up. They will get burnt up. The supply of oxygen will be severed. It will be choked. Then the next steps are browning. The tree will become brownish in color. It will harden. That means it will become hard, stiff. Then it will be distorted out of shape, twisting and withering. It will dry up, and now the objective of killing a tree has been accomplished. So actually, what does the poet want to say? The poet wants to say that man is dependent on trees for his survival, but oblivious to this, eta bisrito hoye bhule giye, man goes on killing trees indiscriminately. Actually, man is digging his own grave, nijer samadhi nijei rachana korche by killing trees. As soon as we understand it, the better, because the existence or the survival of man depends on the survival of trees, and killing trees is nothing but an assault on nature. What is meant by the term assault? Assault means attack. It is an attack on nature, a direct attack on nature, because the tree is very much a part of nature, and the tree grows up by absorbing the elements of nature. So by killing trees, actually we are attacking nature, and nature will retaliate. Retaliate means to give back a blow, pratyaghat kara. Nature will retaliate, and a day may come when human beings will be exterminated from the surface of the earth. So the poet has warned us in this poem that killing a tree is tantamount to an assault on nature, and killing a tree is also equal to the killing of human beings. The word killing is important. Who can be killed? Only a living being can be killed. That means the poet wants to say that killing a tree is tantamount to homicide. Tantamount to means equal to. Gach ka mara mane hoche hottakando. Homicide means murder. Killing a tree is tantamount to homicide. So the word killing. Otherwise the poet could have used the term cutting down a tree or felling a tree. No, killing. That means the poet wants to give us this message that killing a tree is tantamount to murder. That is the justification of its title. I will send you the questions and other notes, the word notes. So we have finished it. Try to understand it. If you have any question, you may send it through WhatsApp or give me a call. Thank you. The class comes to an end today.